Okay, so we just won a pretty close 16-14 there. We got off to a strong start. I think we were 8-2 or something towards the start, and on the switch of the half, it all started going downhill. Forced onto a couple of ecos there, but at the end of the day, we brought it back 16-14. I think we did well. Wong had a very solid performance, and it's good to see someone really shine through in a game and bring the team forward.
Nice.
Against Lucid Esports 16-4, and now we have Choke. We're feeling pretty confident in the minute, and we're hoping to get through the next round.
They woke up quite a bit and things got pretty tough. We ended up losing like 10 rounds in a row to begin with, got one back, and then straight away got reset, and in the end we lost game 16-12, so felt pretty flat after that game. We basically kind of crumbled, but can't say they didn't deserve the win. After losing to Choke, we got knocked into the lower bracket playing a team called Austerity Esports, which going into it we felt quite confident we should steamroll them because we're kind of tougher than we expected to be. I thought we had it in us, and made a couple of mistakes on our part, and then they can eat up the scoreline, and they just ran away with it. And then we ended up losing 16-13, which for us was really disappointing.
So I've just been knocked out of Counter-Strike again, top 16, to God knows, though. I don't know who they were. Considering we had sixth seed, we've been knocked out of top 16. God knows. It's not good enough. Yeah, fucking frustrating. Fucking frustrating.
So after the game, I kind of went outside, had to talk about things. There was a few reasons we had in our mind why we lost. But at the end of the day, it's the best one. So, although we are the better team, we should have won. Yes, anything can happen. Yes,
that's too close.
Yo, those guys are sick.
It's because we waited for 6 fucking hours.
It's first game.
Yeah. I don't really
get it. We owe fucking Jeff a drink now.
So on Friday we participated in the group stage, and there was an issue with the seeding, so we ended up with the best teams in our group.
They've said it's for more inclusive players, so worst teams get in for tomorrow's games.
Right, which is just ridiculous.
That's not at all what
so
I thought.
Two of the best teams here are going to go out today for no reason. Taylor, here's no reason.
You're having a laugh.
We aim to accommodate all skill levels by running this group stage when teams are sorted into either pro or
Indies. That's not what a tournament is!
That's not how you run a tournament! You get the best players to win!
There was a bracket where only two teams turned up, so these two shitters have gone into the next stage.
No!
Yeah. Just not playing a single game.
Which ultimately led us to finish third in our group, and we were expected to be eliminated from competing in the rest of the tournament.
But the problem, how do they even know what skill level of people it is? They split it, between intermediate and advanced. Yeah. But how do they know by the players?
Backboard.
Oh!
I did aim for backboard, but I'm a bean. Just you, nice.
Oh! Nice.
Good pass, guys. Good play.
Very good pass.
Really good mid pass.
I got demo.
Oh. Ah. Shit!
Okay, guys.
He came from the flip and just hit me.
Can we go through now?
I don't know.
So we're gonna go speak to the head admins now, try and get that resolved, because
it's not acceptable that some teams go through with zero wins.
I'm just
over hearing it. It's not a good idea. But.
So we just spoke to the admin, and he said he's sorting it with the head admin because we just realised that two of the teams that went through just happened because there were no other teams in the group. So it's not right considering teams are paid to be here and the teams that have actually got organisations backing them haven't been able to go through.
We thought we were going to be unable to compete for the rest of the tournament, but because there was an issue, we ended up starting in the losers bracket instead of the winners bracket for the Saturday.
So it basically just means we have to win every game, every single game, and can't lose. No pressure.
Again.
One more.
He's missed it.
Hello. How are you?
Fez?
Yeah, not bad.
It's really good, guys. Just keep it up.
That's a nice goal.
That's a nice goal, nice.
You don't know who's gonna go. I'll explain it.
Well, he's on the same side as you.
Geek. Bam.
You'll both hit it. Wherever he hits it, it won't go.
Sorry, it doesn't matter. It's okay. Right. 1-1. We'll get this back. I'm feeling good. Nice!
Nice shot!
Good job, guys.
You're insane.
Yeah, nice.
Hey! Oh!
What a god.
What a god.
I'm middle.
Fuck, it came out. Just you. You got time. That's it. Good clear.
He might whiff.
I got no boost.
Hey, right, I'm middle.
He missed.
Go on.
Yes!
Fuck!
Well done.
But anyway, we made it to top four. Next could be Flip Flop Tic Tac. It's gonna be tough games, but hopefully we can make it.
That works.
Let's go.
This is dope.
Next game's coming up.
Yeah, you're going to be playing play Motion. Have you played Motion yet?
We played Motion and took them to game 5 and lost 3-2.
Ooh.
So it's going to be close, I think. I think it's going to be close. It's going to be hard.
Offense that came out from anyone, but there's a shot from Nice Cubes as he goes up. What a shot this one is. Oh!
Nice.
That was nice.
With your this win.
In regulation, nice. Yes!
Next fucking goal.
Well,
well
done.
So we just played Motion Gaming. We put it in a very difficult series. It wasn't in the end. Beat them 3-0.
We then moved on into the grand finals against our good friends Borzu, who already had a one-game advantage due to coming through the winner's bracket.
Very excited. Ready to play. Keep warm. Go for the win.
Yeah, they are going to be trying taking down the team of Ballers, Epic Toasty, Exposia and Ollie here in the grand finals.
Oh, Junkie!
And Cheeky Lan getting the first goal with a great pass from Junkie. Junkie.
Put it in!
Oh.
Put it in!
They need to get this one in game number 2 and take the lead. After starting a game down, their morale must be through the roof at this point, as a great pass from Junket to Cheeky Lad. 3-0,
yes.
And they have got to be feeling good about themselves. And definitely not going to do it with 0 seconds left on the clock, but you can score one as Cheeky Lad does it. Flicks it off the wall, very good play.
But Cheeky Lad, 5 goals in one game. I don't think I've seen that in a long time in a competitive match of Rocket League.
They've not been putting on their best performances in these last few games, but Barrage have been absolutely incredible.
to witness, and Boz really needs to turn.
How many more? Okay, two more?
I just have to win one more.
Is it one more?
Yes, one more.
Alright, let's go.
No one wants to be the person who gives away the game. Oh! This nice cube gives away the game by touching it down to the middle. Epic Toasty reading it completely and putting that goal in as our crowd goes wild. The Boz team not really making any team plays at the moment, but that is the fault of Barrage shutting those team plays down before they even happen.
20 seconds.
And with 20 seconds left, this could be it. And with an open net cleared away by Ollie, could this be it? 10 seconds left. They need to hold, and Barrage will be our champions in 5 seconds time, or will they? Ollie going to take this one up the wall. Epic Toasty looking to find it. It's going to go on net. It's going to touch the ground. And Barrage Esports are your Insomnia 61 Grand Champions.
Taking the win home was really good. It all felt great. Especially for Nice Cubed, who it was his, I think, 5th Insomnia taking part in the Rocket League.
What a turnaround from yesterday, being out to winning.
So him taking home the first place prize after all those attempts is really good for him. I'm sure he's feeling great. We had a big audience following us into that grand finals. Hearing all of them cheer when we got that win, it just made everything so much better, because the community is so great for it, for Rocket League. Everyone's good friends with each other, and it all feels brilliant when we got that win. So potentially looking forward for our Rocket League team is a coach who can give us critical feedback, who can review and analyse our replays to tell us what to improve on, improve our positioning, give us individual feedback, give us team feedback. Because winning this meant that we know that we can take it further. And it's a serious thing.
Cheers, Jeff.
So you